It goes back to this sense of this idea in nature that and the sort of fundamental law that everything is in process, nothing static, and life is beginning and ending and dying all at exactly the same time.
Yeah, let's just give it one wipe over, Carlos.
Sure. Positive.
When we clear coat it, it'll drop back a lot.
Let's get into kind of what you're known for now. You have two really distinct styles and types of work. You have the dark two-dimensional drawings, which are done on a variety of surfaces, and then you have the three-dimensional sculptures that are bright and really beautiful, full of color.
Yeah.
Why two different, I mean, two polar ends, emotionally, physically, you know, mentally?
Well, you know, for me, they're all part of the same conversation. They're just different aspects of it. The two-dimensional drawing, the sculpture really came out of the two-dimensional drawing, which is kind of funny that it was sort of reversed. But the carbon drawings were. I started trying to, you know, I wanted to try and draw in a three-dimensional way. I was looking to try and describe something that was not quite there, something that I could, that you could feel rather than you could see. And I started with the smoke, sort of was the mark making that I gave me the ability to do something that was that diffuse and that was in a process, I guess.
Did you start with the smaller drawings? I mean, you've done some drawings just using, pencils or lead or carbon pencils. Is that what
yes,
you used?
Yes. Yeah.
They were before I take it, the bigger panels.
There was some small carbon drawing on with graphite on paper, but very quickly I realized, you know, it's a very physical thing that I'm really trying to talk about your physical space, and that scale is a very important part of my work, and that you need to have a physical relationship with the form and the shape. So I ended up scaling it up very quickly and working actually very large very early on.
Well, yeah, the forms you use and the shapes are really as basic as you can get. You use lines and circles and squares. I mean, is that kind of paring down everything to their essence?
Yeah, very much so. Yeah. And I think it falls back to sort of this, again, these shapes you see repeated in nature, like the, and that have a constant, the circle and the dots are you know, intentionally ambiguous, that it goes back between something that could be micro or macro, or your sense of, and that's back to the physical aspect of it again, as well as the sense of scale and your perspective.
If you're talking about nature, mm-hmm. and you are, mm-hmm. why the darker colors then? Why, you know, pretty much browns or blacks, or, you know, instead of, you know, a lot of people would think of nature as green or blue or, you know, flowers mm-hmm. and things like that. So why the darkness?
Well, it's part of how I'm making the mark, and using the carbon, I think, is an important part of that. It's just really simple, primary way of making a mark, and this the simplicity, the positive and the negative, I think that there is between just this shades of light and gray, and I wanted it to be that simple, to be just this pull in between, somewhere in between the positive and the negative, I think is kind of what we see.
Well, that's what I was going to, you know, get into. And your positive and negative space, it seems to be all over your work. I mean, that seems to be
absolutely
the pulling and pushing and what's in there. Mm-hmm. But let's talk about, you know, the more personal aspect of it. You know, I mean, mm-hmm. I think these are, in a lot of ways, saying something about what's inside of you. Do you see them that way?
Yeah, very much so. It's how I feel about me in the world, my place in the world. And it's a very, very personal thing that I can't describe it in a, literally, it's a physical.
This is the language you use to describe yourself and the world you see, mm-hmm. right? This is your language.
Exactly. Yeah.
And I guess, you know, this is the way I see it, after going so deeply into yourself, because you do spend time, at least I do, looking at these, you know, into mm-hmm. to the void or into the space or into the future or into the past, all these different things can come out looking at it. Did you want to kind of get away from that when you went to the sculptures? Because the sculptures kind of, you know, they're very pointy and they kind of push you back. They're very beautiful, but it's a whole different experience looking at them than looking at the panels.
With the sculptural work, I really wanted your experience of it to be a lot more immediate, a lot more direct. I think with the carbon drawing, it's about looking. I hope there's something that's somewhat eternal about what's happening there, and that's that you're looking forward and back. And it is immediate, but it's a larger connection, where with the sculptural work, it's very much about engaging you in the present and bringing you to the right now. And the first piece I did was the big, large star pieces, which mm-hmm. really actually does that, because there's 720 castings coming out from a central core. And the light starts to, when they're polished aluminum, so, and they're cast, triangles, tapers. So they've got facets on the sides, and that picks up the light on the exterior. And then as you get in, start looking into the center, but the light just starts to disappear. It becomes a kind of a black hole. So I think that does, but it's a very different, completely different experience than the two-dimensional work. It is a lot more, I think, visceral, immediate, and direct an experience than what's happening with the drawing.
How did you come to choose the colors that you use in those?
As you know, color is a very, so it was a new thing to me with the sculpture. And, excuse me, I have a very primary sense of color, like as much as the carbon and it being rather a material and something that's very base. The same approach with the color, that with the red piece, the big red resin wallflower. I wanted it. It just had to be this, you know, blood red that was felt just so base and primary, and the same with the yellow. So there, I'm dealing with color in that way.
In the same way?
Same way, as I found the carbon.
Yeah. The idea of carbon, you know, because it's a very basic element, it's in everything. Did everybody think about, is that something why you wanted to work with?
Yeah, it is. Absolutely.
Okay.
And, you know, and it goes back to the first marks we've ever made was carbon on cave walls.
Right.
So it has that element too.
You know. Now let's talk about other artists.
Kashmir Malevich was a big, very early influence on me when I saw his Black Square the first time. I just couldn't believe it. I was really bowled over that someone could do something that was so simple and primary, and yet just felt like it had the whole world in it, in this just small, you know, and they're little paintings. They're not they're not that very big, but that really.
All right, let's just talk a little bit about the smaller pieces that you mm-hmm. do. What do you get out of those that you can't get out of the big ones, and I guess vice versa?
Well, the carbon drawing, I should do quite a bit of it on paper, directly on paper. And there's a lovely immediacy with the paper. Again, it's my experience, and I can bang out ideas so much quicker when it's this big, whereas the big panel pieces take a week to prep, and then we do it, and then it doesn't work, and we just had 2 weeks, and we got to start all over again. And so that's a long process, and whereas with the smaller work, even on panel, but I can experiment and push myself a bit, and that's really important to be able to do work and let it fail, and mm-hmm. you haven't just spent a month of time getting there. So there's that, and the immediacy of the experience of me is making the work is great.
Do you try at all to take the, you know, what you've done in a small one and replicate it in the larger ones?
Yeah, absolutely. I'll you know, particularly with, you know, positioning and scale of a form, I'll get a sense of it with the drawing, with the smaller drawings, and then understand what I can do with the bigger piece. So yeah, absolutely.
You talked about the two-dimensional, three-dimensional space. Are you looking for an object that speaks to those spaces? And why? I mean, what is it about the dimensions that you try to grab?
It goes back to this sense of this idea in nature and this sort of fundamental law that everything is in process and nothing static, and life is beginning and ending and dying all at exactly the same time. And I wanted to try and do that in a physical way, get a sense of that energy and that things are constantly expanding and contracting, and to see if I could make a sculpture that really felt that way. And that's what I wanted to achieve with the two pieces. They draw to each other, they're pulled, they're not just a symmetric. And it started with the carbon drawing, with the first big sculpture I made from the big star piece, was I had a big carbon drawing that's two spots of carbon that just slowly grow out and disappear into the white. And there was a very much an energy of that was sort of molecular of these two things drawing towards each other. And I wanted to communicate, part of that, of this, you know, molecular, cellular energy that's all around us.